Asakura Hao has the godlike ability to reincarnate. The name of this technique is the Taizan Fukando Sai. It is because of this ability, Hao was able to incarnate back on Earth to experience three lifetimes. It is through these lifetimes, Hao's grudge against humanity continued to flare until it became a blaze of hatred. In Hao's first life, he was born with demonic powers and the gift to see spirits. Hao's mother, Asanoha, had this blessing as well, and this led to Hao's belief that he was the son of a demon, or so he thought.
The son of a demon. To me, you just seem like a normal human's kid.
Why do you follow me?
Oh, why not? We really don't have anything else to do anyway. And besides, there aren't that many humans who can speak to demons.
You say strange things. The reason why I can talk to demons is because I'm the son of a demon. To say that I'm just human.
Ha! So you believed it when they said your mom was a fox in disguise? Bullseye. Well, these days it's a normal thing, I guess. All the sickness in the mountains of dead bodies. A place full of bad things like this. Something has to be blamed. Because if they say it was a human's fault, it all got like this, that would sound stupid, right?
What are you trying to say?
It's not like we demons go around doing evil things. We just came here because we felt like this place was a great place to settle. Just think about it. Why exactly do you think the stories attacking demons are born? Yes, it's because there are also others who can see us demons. Humans are such cowards. They fear everything they can't see or understand. They give a reason for everything, just to feel relieved. That's why your mom was murdered. Because she could see demons and talk to demons, they believed she was a fox in disguise. Foxes can't disguise themselves as humans. If they were to have such powers, they would probably choose to change into something much better.
The son of the fox.
Demon child. Fox child.
Come on, show your true form. My dad saw it, you know. Your mom talking to herself. Officer, it's this woman.
Tie her down. Let's just burn down the entire house with her. She will surely show her true form.
Not the son of a demon? And I don't have its powers either?
Of course you're not. You're just a brat who can see us demons. So stop thinking about stupid things. Revenge is something the stupid humans do.
So then, what am I supposed to do? How am I supposed to live from now on?
Let's play. My name is Ochachio. You don't have anything to do, right? Let's become friends.
From this point on, Hao became best friends with the Oni, Ochachio, who then teaches Hao how to read and write, and eventually, how to live. Until one day, a monk discovers Hao's demonic powers. Because of this, Hao is then hunted. In order to protect himself, Hao uses these same demonic powers to form an oversoul with Ochachio.
Ho ho ho! Just as expected from the demon's child. You seem to have powers far more stronger than a human. I see it was a right thing for me to come.
But boss, there's something strange about this brat.
He runs around as if he can read our thoughts, and it seems like he has a weapon that we can't see.
That is the power of a demon.
Like that is possible.
The only demons that exist are the ones born from one's own dark thoughts.
The ones who go around saying that demons are attacking. They're the true evil. The real demons. If you can erase all those who can see demons, then in the end, no one will remain who says demons exist. Is that how you want to solve the problems, Monk Densen?
What on earth are you trying to say, demon child?
How did that brat know?
I can read the thoughts of people. That is the demon power that Ochachio gave me.
Ochachio?
You are a monk, so why can't you see this weapon of mine?
But from this point forward into the fight, it's no longer about self-defense.
You've already learned how to use it, but we should stop now. Because if not, then you won't be able to take this out of yourself anymore.
Sorry, but I cannot do that.
Huh? What are you saying all of a sudden? Isn't it enough that you can scare these guys away?
Isn't this power great, Ochachio? If I can read the thoughts of others, then they won't be able to defeat me. I can also learn anything I want in this way. That guy, he's the one who killed my mother.
You can't go back and change the past. Listen up closely, before my soul becomes totally controlled by you.
You said, your mom? So this brat was the Asanoha woman's son. I knew it was not smart to not kill him back then. Could it be that I'm dreaming? Or,
I'm really sorry about what happened. Why don't you listen to me? I might be able to help you.
What? What exactly is going on here? No matter what, I must do something. Ta!
I'm sorry, Ochachio.
Eh? Ah! What is this? No! I don't want to die! 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 Mommy!
So small. Hao eventually became one of the things he hated most.
In the end, we could not become friends, huh, Mappa Doji? It is not my intention to seek revenge. It's normal for living things to fight in battle. I'm just a demon, born from the dirty soul of a human. I liked you, who hated all other humans, and was as pure as a demon. When I was still a human, the only thing I ever did was measure other people's attitudes. But when I turned into an ability, it merged with you. You took over my soul. Now this ability will stay with you forever. But because of this, I cannot stay by your side. I don't mind if you want to go and kill all humans. But the fact that that is what you're thinking about doing is the best proof that you are also just a human. So goodbye, human.
Humans thrive off of their own desires. They do things solely for the benefit of themselves. This is what Ochachio and Hao hated about them. Humans never try to understand, and what they don't understand is either wrong or evil. The entire time they called shamans demons, because they didn't understand them, when in actuality, shamans help the earth and its people. The entire time, those demonic powers were actually the powers of a shaman. People who can see ghosts aren't bad people. That should give you a rough idea on the type of people they were getting killed in Shaman King. And these monks took advantage of shamans, all for their own personal gain. Humans are selfish. Nobody does anything unless it's for themselves. This world is going to shit. Let's blame it on demons. This world is going to shit. Maybe it's God punishing us. Maybe the world is going to shit because of our own actions. We are constantly asking ourselves, what more can we do? But to be honest, no one ever actually tries to do anything except for make up excuses and lounge around. The sad reality is that the Earth, our home, our own planet, would be better off without us. As humans, we are blessed with the freedom of choice, yet we only choose for ourselves. We take advantage, we conquer, and we blame others for our actions. Our best way at solving a problem is by simply ignoring it. Hundreds of years have passed, and still nothing has changed. Let's look at how we're dealing with global warming. Our world is slowly melting, and nobody gives a shit.
But what can we do? How can we fix the world? How can we stop global warming and pollution? What can us normal people do?
We all know damn well what we should do in order to get this fixed. And because we will never act on it, we are no different than the same evil humans that we let take advantage of us. We feed dumbass rappers money that probably don't even know how to spell charity. We feed rich businessmen money who are probably involved with sex trafficking. And we sit on our asses, make excuses, and won't ever do anything about it. Do you think that God will honestly care about our excuses once the planet is finally gone or uninhabitable? Because of these people that are on top of the food chain, won't do anything about it, and are taking advantage of everyone? And then we just sit there and let them do it? Then when push comes to shove at the end of it all, we will all be surprised once we're all burning in hell or extinct. This is why Hao hates humans. Everyone truly lives for themselves. The monk that killed Hao's mother is a perfect example of the self-centered mentality humanity has. Despite killing Hao's mother, in the monk's final moments, we see him crying for his own mom. Imagine what Hao felt in that moment. Imagine what you'd feel in that moment. The man who deprived you of your mother's love then cries out for the same love he took away from you. Not even considering what he's done to you because of his own narcissistic train of thought. This is what human nature is. Even Hao himself is no exception to that. To live for yourself is to be human. Outside of revenge, there was no reason for Hao to kill that monk. He killed him for his own personal gain. This is why Ochachio left Hao, because he became what they both hated most, human. I told you long ago that I hadn't changed my mind about killing humans on Earth, and that I'd attentively watch all of you try to fix everything before your time runs out. So, how does it feel having to leave Hana behind in order to travel around the world? Exactly, Yo. As long as people continue to exist, our world will be filled with conflict. Hao is not joking in the slightest. As Hao's first life as Mappa Doji continues, he is taken under by an Omnioji named Tadatomo and begins to make friends with Tadatomo's first apprentice, Daitaro, who was originally jealous of Hao.
What the hell? Has Tadatomo-sama taught him how to write too?
It wasn't Tadatomo-sama. Believe it or not, it was an Oni I learned this from. Don't worry, you didn't say it out loud. That Oni gave me the power to read people's minds too. So take this advice as a token of courtesy towards my senior apprentice. Tadatomo-sama's too powerful, even for me to read his mind. You should give up before he finds out about that plan of yours.
What?
Wow, I see. So an Oni actually... Well, I don't have any stories like that, but see my face? I've always been alone because of this birthmark. People think it's gross. At some point, I started seeing Onis too. Then Tadatomo-sama took me in, and here I am. But are you sure it's alright to spend your time with a traitor like me? I'm not interested in taking sides, so I don't really care about that. I've seen way too many things I didn't want to because of my power. Beautiful things, filthy things, abundance, and also poverty. So there's one thing I know for sure. Whether their intentions are good or bad, the truth is, all people live only for themselves. For themselves? Stealing things away from others, be it charity or even love. That Oni told me this.
I don't mind if you want to go and kill all humans, but the fact that that is what you're thinking about doing is the best proof that you are also just a human.
If so, then I want to transcend humanity. Someday, after I surpass Tadatomo-sama, I'd like to see the world ahead and be free no matter where I go, even if that made God and Buddha turn against me.
I had no idea you were this amusing, Mappa Doji. Nice. Then let me join you in your little quest. And while on this quest, Hao begins to realize the truth about humans. Hao's initial thoughts on humans played out right before him. Hao was right all along.
Ooh, so pleasing to the eye. This is exactly the wonderful, elegant dance I expected from Hamodono.
With this Oni exercising ceremony and its magnificent beauty, the Onis will surely be gone once and for all.
What a bunch of superficial pigs. Sucking others dry, indulging in every possible luxury, when people outside the capital are suffering. Without even noticing their auto-destructive behavior, those poor fools keep attracting Onis with their acts. Same goes for those in the streets. They're nothing but cattle, living a lie, not even trying to do something about it. That's why I'm not interested in taking sides. But if everyone's living only for themselves, then the last one standing gets the world. And I wouldn't mind having some more people with my same powers in that world. At least, that way, living in this rotten place wouldn't suck as much. All I can do until I become stronger is keep bearing all this. But... Daitaro, are you really going through with it? Of course I am, Mappa Doji. I'm really jealous of you, but believe it or not, I'm actually very thankful to Tadatomo-sama. I know that, but... Then you should understand without me telling you. Despite being extremely powerful, Doma was defeated in a fight that caused him to lose his position as head Omni-Oji. After that, he's tried to ruin the Oni exercising ceremony every year to get revenge on Tadatomo-sama for what he did. You should see how stylish Tadatomo-sama always looks when he's repelling Doma. Isn't it funny? He doesn't realize that he's actually making Tadatomo-sama more and more popular every time he tries to boycott the ceremony. That's why I decided to use him this time. At least, I'd like to bring some hope to my life.
Please, step back! Tadatomo-sama, I can handle this. You'll see.
Oh, who's that unpleasant kid?
Are you trying to sabotage the ceremony?
Stay calm. Ladies and gentlemen, countless Oni have suddenly appeared.
What?
Tadatomo-sama! Now if you'd please, let me perform the actual exercising ceremony. Come on, Onis! Reveal your true form!
Huh? What?
This is it, Mappa Doji. I spent my life showing these pigs all the power we Omni-Oji have. Finding a way to make them see how superior we actually are. I even joined forces with Doma to perform some experiments. Today, in this very place, I'm going to show you all the ultimate fruits of our research. Behold, born out of pure despair, a physical being between man and Oni, Daitaro Boshi, the human Shikigami.
What was that, Tadatomo? What on earth is happening here? Death is the filthiest thing one can bring to the capital. How dare you? In front of the Emperor!
Just as expected from the Minister, you could successfully see through the Oni. The city's overflowing with them, and they have been awaiting a chance to prey upon us and take revenge. But to think that, of all people, it was my own apprentice who got possessed by them, I feel mortified. As his mentor, it is my duty to take responsibility for what has happened.
Oh. What's Tadatomo-sama saying? He's making everything up. Is this what he calls courtesy? No. I couldn't care less about that.
Daitaro respected you more than anyone else! How dare you do this to him!
Hold him down! Zenki! Goki!
Get off of me!
If I don't help Daitaro, he'll... I already had this in mind when I picked him up. Don't interfere in my plans, Mappa Doji. You, more than anyone, should know that you don't stand a chance against me. But since you, too, are strong, you'll eventually understand it. Understand how absurdly irrational this world is. The least I can do is watch over you until that day comes. Come on, Daitaro! Show him the resentment in our world!
What is that thing?
Oh, at last. At last. Here it is! All of those years of experimenting have finally paid off. A physical human Oni everyone is able to see. It's breathtaking. My human Shikigami died.
That thing stomped on. Tadatomo Dono.
Run! Get out of my way! An Oni! Who's stepping on my sleeve?
The head Omni-Oji's been crushed by that Oni.
Tadatomo-sama, what is the meaning of this? Tadatomo-sama!
Everything that Hao is saying still happens in our world to this day. Hundreds of years later, and still, nothing has changed.
You'd think that you could separate the good humans from the evil humans, but no, we are all the same. To be good or evil is subjective at the end of the day, because both sides are still selfish within their own right. Good or bad, both sides are inevitably in the wrong.
You must run away, Mappa Doji. The Shikigami's vanishing like that means that Tadatomo is already dead. Nobody can stop Daitaro Boshi. At least not until all his resentment runs out.
But Senior Apprentice, I...
Do you want Tadatomo's death to be in vain? Tadatomo wanted this to happen. From the very beginning. After all, the grudge he held against this world was as big as yours. The capital's been treating all the death and illnesses around as something impure. Their solution being to pretend it's not there. The meaning of the name Hyen, peace and tranquility, sounds ironic when you realize that it's just a smokescreen for a society that solves its problems by ignoring them. That thing's a mass of resentment from the tormented souls that can't rest in peace. This city had it coming all along. They were asking for this. It just happened a bit sooner than expected. Still don't understand it, Mappa Doji? This is our battle. Our chance to break the control these filthy men have over us.
Doma. Yamada.
Come with me, Mappa Doji. Now that Tadatomo's dead, you must survive in order to take over for him.
I see. Is that it then?
Huh?
You all are cut from the same cloth, aren't you? It seems that victims are always necessary when it comes to gaining power.
Is what Hal realized in his first life as Mappa Doji, before he officially became Hal and started the Asakura clan. As Hal's first life continued, he still held on to his grudge against humanity. But despite this, Hal never stopped trying to save the world. This is why he wants all humans gone, because the world would be better off without them. Humans are all cut from the same cloth, and victims are always necessary when it comes to gaining power. Tadatomo sacrificed Daitaro, the one who loved him the most out of everyone, for what he believed to be the greater good. Is that not just another selfish act of evil? You could argue for both sides on whether or not it was good or evil, and this is what makes all humans the same. I felt like Daitaro's sacrifice was for the greater good. I felt like Daitaro's death was wrong. But regardless on which side you choose, you are acting out of your own self-regarding instincts. If Daitaro didn't die, the filthy men that ruled over everyone would have continued to do so, and the souls of the people who suffered from this cycle would have remained tormented, and the people who continued to live would have been forgotten to death and illness, and then that would continue to bring more tortured souls, and this cycle would continue to repeat. People will continue to die, and their souls will be forever tormented. This is all true. But did Daitaro have to die in such a cruel way? And the answer to that is, no, he didn't. Even though, people would still argue, what is one life to the lives of many? This argument is wrong. And I, like these same people, used to think like this. What is one life to the lives of thousands? The math says that 1,000 lives are better than one life. And that is definitely true. But I think the real question here is, can math really determine the value of somebody's life? If somebody were to make more money than you, does that automatically mean that their life is worth more? No, it doesn't. Can your personality make you worth more than the next human? No, because this is all wrong. You cannot put a numerical value on life. Because if you do, that just makes you selfish. Because your value will always be different compared to someone else's. In other words, it will always be a matter of opinion. And to have your opinion determine somebody's life worth is wrong. And a number shouldn't change that. Shaman King is a story about love, and over time, humanity's absence of it. Tadatomo, like Hal, resents humanity for its evil and absence of love, due to humanity's own selfishness. But Tadatomo does not realize that he is a part of that problem. He believed that if he sacrificed Daitaro, he would have brought that love back. But in actuality, he was the one who was selfish and had forgotten how to love. Because he killed Daitaro, the one that loved him the most, for his own selfishness, for what he believed to be the greater good. Tadatomo, just like Hao, was selfish, and he became what he hated most, human. The superficial pigs are evil because they want to live better. Those in the streets are good because they also want to live better. Both are selfish and each have their own sense of justice. I deserve to be in the position that I'm in. I don't deserve to be in the position that I'm in. And the cycle continues. This selfishness is the unavoidable truth. Regardless of being good or evil, both were inevitably the same. Both sides were cut from the same cloth of human desires and were made solely for the benefit of themselves. In the end, both sides are selfish because they both strive for the same thing. They just want better living conditions. As Hao began to grow older in his first life as Mappa Doji, he eventually became an Omnioji and took on his new name as Asakura Hao, which then led to the creation of the Asakura clan. Despite this, Hao was lonesome. With the ability to read minds, his grudge against humanity, and the countless Oni that would follow him, would be the cause of this loneliness. Until one fateful night, Hao's loneliness came to an end. During that shaman fight, 500 years ago, you killed your own master with your own hands.
You mean, you think I really regret that?
Isn't it so? That's why. You are unable to be reincarnated, even now.
I suppose that's obviously the truth. Why did I do that? To that person, I could never forget the feelings of respect I have for Hao-sama.
It's become much colder.
Yep, it has. And the smell has gotten worse. These bodies, this really is troublesome. The deceased of poor families who are unable to afford a proper burial are all tossed here.
And because the dirt and germs flow everywhere, epidemics develop and more people die, abandoning people in the streets, leaving them to die. This has already become a common habit. No wonder the world is going to end.
No way. Please don't let them appear.
What? What can it be?
Obviously anything that appears here will be one of those legendary Oni.
Don't fool around. What if it really does come? Then we're...
Ah! It's appeared! Crap! It's only a cat and yet it wants to try and scare us, eh?
What's more, sleeping amidst a pile of bones. You disrespectful little thing, I'm going to kill you.
Stop it. No matter how weak it is, it's still a living being. We cannot kill something without having a reason.
But it's only a scrawny cat!
Isn't it extraordinary? It's all alone in this capital of human destruction, and it escaped the wrath of death. You have not only been forsaken by your parents, but your seven brothers and sisters have all perished. And you also know that you have contracted diseases and are on the verge of death. But that brave soul of yours is devoid of the fear towards Oni. How can I leave you here alone? You should be able to see. Come to my side.
The Oni are afraid of him, and even the feared god spirits listen to him. A master of the shaman and Itako arts, the known Omnioji, Asakura Hao.
No one can be as gentle as him.
How can you bear to say that he is gentle? Didn't you defeat him?
Together with Asakura Yoken's attack. Even though he did not become the Shaman King, he was still reincarnated into the Patch Tribe 500 years earlier. Despite having the ability to read minds, Hao was still gentle and kind to everyone. Despite his grudge against humanity, he was still caring and compassionate. Until one day, Hao lost his sanity.
Hao was good to everyone, but because of that good nature and his incredible shamanic powers, his heart was consumed by Oni. Reishi, without having to look or listen,
He can understand other people's feelings and minds, but that power, the stronger it got, the more out of control it became. Finally, it got to the stage where people's feelings started to flow in against his will, and all the deep thoughts of grudge and hatred finally started to poison his own heart as well, leading to the birth of an Oni. In that era of ghostly terror, where the word peace didn't exist, in the midst of the suffering people, as well as the greedy nobles who caused this plight, the darkness that Hao saw was unthinkable.
So that's why Hao wanted to become Shaman King. But that doesn't mean he was gentle. Instead, he was weak. I suppose the darkness at the time isn't something that we can think of, but that cannot change the fact that Hao is unable to fight the darkness in his heart. Didn't you know of this, Matamune? And isn't this one of the reasons why you fought him as well?
Of course. I still maintain that justice to this day. But my heart now regrets deeply because I couldn't choose the things that are most important to me.
I don't know what counts as justice either, but at least I know what's right from wrong.
Hao is not evil. Hao's intentions were never evil, but they were wrong. Just like his master Tadatomo's plan to save people at Daitaro's expense. If killing the humans and killing Daitaro were all for the greater good, would that make both of their actions justified, despite these actions being evil or wrong? These actions may be wrong, but it is inevitably for the greater good. Hao is a walking contradiction. He is no different than Tadatomo, and they are both no different than the humans they hate. Both of their journeys and plans to try and save humanity just made them a part of the same cycle that they hate so much. Like Tadatomo said, the world is absurdly irrational. Despite this, Hao still tried his hardest to save the world by making the Asakura clan. The Asakura clan protect the world and save people. That alone should say enough about Hao's motives. Because if it wasn't for Hao, the Asakura clan wouldn't exist. If Hao were to make his clan solely for the benefit of humanity, does that not say enough about his character? Ever since Hao lost his battle with the Reishi, he was at a constant battle with his own clan, the clan that he started. Hao's children and grandchildren turned against him, along with the other Asakura family branches, and he became the biggest threat to the Asakuras. All of Hao's teachings, as the father of the Asakura clan, were put against him. The Asakura clan, the family that Hao started, Hao's descendants had to fight the man that gave them everything. Their customs, their beliefs, and practices were put to the ultimate test, as well as Hao's resolve to fix the world. And this test inevitably led to Hao's death. But the efforts of the Asakura clan were not enough, because Hao came back a second time. During Hao's second life, he came back to Earth as a member of the Patch tribe. In the Shaman Fight, he was known as the Devil Patch for how cruel and merciless he was. As the Devil Patch, Hao had one goal, and that goal was to make a world fit for shamans. He was going to eradicate every normal human that wasn't a shaman in order to save the Earth, until he was betrayed by the same shamans that he wanted to save. In the world of Shaman King, shamans are dying out due to the industrialization of society. People are forgetting about the importance of nature. After all, humans are a part of nature. And if we destroy nature, we are unavoidably destroying ourselves along with the Earth. But how would humans ever understand that? The sad truth is that they don't, and they probably never will, because we forgot how to love life and love each other. We take our lives for granted, and we forgot just how valuable they really are. Hao, like Tadatomo, is making the wrong choice for the greater good, but in the end, he will forever be a part of the cycle that he hates so much. There is no real good or evil on this earth, because both choices are and always will be wrong, because they will always be selfish. You can't blame Hao, because he sees the truth. All the dark, disgusting, and obscene thoughts that humans hide in the back of their heads. He's seen the evils of humanity firsthand. He was betrayed by his own clan, and eventually, by the shaman world as a whole. But the betrayal that hurt the most was from his best friend. The birth of Asakura Hao's third life is a perfect example of how irrational human nature actually is. Truly, there really is no exception for how selfish humans can be. And those exceptions do not exclude Tadatomo, Hao, or even the Asakuras themselves.
The child in the womb is doing well. You are sure that it is Hao, right?
I have. Up until today, I have performed and repeated the divination many times. But the result was always the same! You bastard, Hao! Going so far as to enter the womb of my daughter!
To Hao, a priestess who has protected the Asakura, is the right person more than anyone else.
But because of his lineage, we know beforehand that he is being reincarnated. Thus, we must make the first move. I feel sorry for Keiko, but we have no other choice. As soon as the child in which he dwells is born, we must kill it.
But Yome, what if they're twins?
What did you say?
Keiko went to see a doctor. Two boys, and what's more, they are identical twins.
You probably can't tell the difference just by looking. And on top of that, you can't tell from your divinations which one is being born first and which is second, right?
That's right.
Even though the aura is strong, we still cannot be sure which child Hao's spirit will be in. Yome, the one who decides is you.
I don't care! We'll have to kill both!
Choosing the fate of the world, or choosing your own son's life, the greater good would be to save the world, but choosing to kill your own son is just wrong. Good or evil, both of these choices are wrong. You're either too selfish by choosing your son, or humanity is too selfish by making you kill your son. Think about it. Would you really want to live in a world where you'd have to kill your own son to save it? Of course, as humans, we cannot be weak. But is this weakness not what makes us human? Unlike Tadatomo, who lacked love and was selfish for what he believed to be the greater good, Yome had love for his grandson and was inevitably too selfish to kill him for the greater good of humanity. But regardless, both of these sides are the same because they are both selfish. Tadatomo arguably made the right choice to save humanity, but Yome made the wrong choice by damning humanity. But Tadatomo also made the wrong choice by killing someone who loved him, and Yome made the right choice by not killing his own son. Both sides are and always will be selfish and wrong, and this cycle is the cycle Hao wants to put an end to. To give you a good idea on the selfishness of humanity, if you were God and you saw one man sacrifice his son for humanity while everyone else treated it as if it was his duty to be strong enough to sacrifice his own son, would you not think or feel as if humanity were barbaric and lacked compassion? What if the world were to continue to thrive off of the blood of this child and they were all content with it? I don't know about you, but that would make me want to start over, make the world reset. But you know what would truly move me? If humanity were beautiful enough to not put the next man through that heartache. What if we were all to agree that if this child were to die for the sake of the human race, it would be wrong for us to put that burden on someone? What if humanity were to realize what true strength is? Strength is not putting all of your burdens on another, but instead dealing with these burdens yourself. Dealing with these burdens together. What if we all stood up and died with dignity? Because if we were to put that man through that hardship for our own conceitedness, would we even be human anymore? If we're strong enough to say that as a human race, we cannot accept those terms, and we face death together as a species that loved one another, would that not be something to be proud of? Would that not move you? If you are God, and the human race put aside its selfishness in this moment,
Would you really be able to put an end to the Earth? If I were God, I don't think I could. But unfortunately, the human race isn't capable of doing that. So can you even really blame Hal for coming to his decision? Humans were narcissistic when it came to the death of his mother. Hal was shown that regardless of being good or evil, both sides are inevitably selfish. He was betrayed by his family and the shaman world as a whole, and was murdered by his best friend and a descendant of his own clan. But not only this, because of his ability to read minds, Hal was able to see the unthinkable darkness of humanity. You can't blame Hal because he is making the right choice, but just like every choice I mentioned before, it is unfortunately the wrong choice as well. Hal wanted to become a demon, so he could be pure like Ochachio, but instead, he became a demon that more or less fit the description of a human. He wasn't a pure demon, but instead, he became a demon that was human-like. Hopefully, you realize by now that there are two definitions for strength, two definitions for humans, and two definitions for demons. In terms of strength, you could be strong enough to sacrifice your child for the sake of the world, or you could be strong enough to say that that is wrong and die with dignity. I'll let you, the viewer, determine which one of these is real strength. In terms of the definition of being human, you can be a selfish monster, or you can have a good sense of morality. And again, I'll let you determine what being human is. When it comes to being a demon, you can be a grotesque monster, or a pure being without malice, treachery, or evil intent. Hal wanted to be pure, but ended up being the exact opposite of pure. This all started when he wanted power for his own selfish reasons. Hal wanted strength, but this same strength is what makes us forget what love is. This isn't real strength. This is what humanity's misinterpretation of strength is. You're not strong for killing your son for the greater good, because this is something no human should have to do or want to do. Our weakness in this situation is what makes us human and keeps us from being selfish monsters. Just like how we misinterpreted the definition of strength, we also misinterpreted the definition of being human. In other words, we forgot how to be human. Hal is the strongest. He has no weaknesses, and this is why he is no longer human. Hal strived to be a pure demon like Ochachio, but instead, he became a demon that fit every aspect he hated about humans. He was selfish, merciless, and forgot how to love. As humans, we must remember what being human is, and we must remember what true strength is. It's okay to be weak, because our weaknesses are what make us who we are. We get so caught up in chasing power, we forget who we are, and become the type of humans we shouldn't be. The humans that resemble demons. Hal wanted to be pure like Ochachio, but failed to realize that he was already pure like him. While chasing this power to be like Ochachio, he became the exact opposite of what he wanted to be. He forgot himself, inevitably making Hal a hypocrite to further fuel the hellfires of humanity and eventually lead to the burning of our planet. But we can prevent this. We can change the definition of humans, the definition of strength, and become pure. But it all depends on you, the viewer, your determination, your laziness, and your selfishness. I've done the best I can to inform you, and hopefully I played my part, because we're all in this together, and one day, we can all remember how to love and be human again.